joined in the Castle Bar County Centre by Rose Conway Walsh. Rose, an incredible weekend to be member Sinn Féin. What's happening here now?
Indeed it has. We're now on Tuesday and Tuesday afternoon, and we've seen Matt Carthy for the 10th time in the last couple of days, and we're still waiting for him to get the transfers. But he's got a huge vote, and we're very confident that at some time later today we will have a European MEP in the west of Ireland, and I know he covers other areas, but we've the interest in the west of Ireland for the first time ever. So I suppose we've waited many years for this, so we're looking forward to this afternoon to Matt getting over the line. And of course Matt will be joining Martina Anderson and Lynn Boylan and Leon Nerida, so we'll have a very strong team going out to Europe, and we very much look forward to working with them here. And of course Sinn Féin have done hugely well across the island, and it looks like we've trebled our number of seats in local government across the country, and that'll make a huge difference to us as well. It's not about Sinn Féin at the end of the day getting into power, it's about us giving back the power to the people, the power that has been sucked away from people over the decades, and we have an opportunity to empower the people here and to create the public that we've always wanted here. So it is very exciting times.
Councillor Maria Farrell. Gorgeous. We've been dispatched from Belfast just to have this interview. Apparently some guy called Matt Carthy's also getting elected. But anyway, how did your campaign go, and what's your thoughts about how this is going for Matt?
Well, we're absolutely delighted in Galway West. I mean, we went from no councillors to 5, so it was a fantastic result. But we're really here, and we can't wait to see Matt Carthy, to have our own MEP, to join the other 3 MEPs, and to really have a Team Sinn Féin out in Europe.
The Team Sinn Féin brand seemed to resonate with people all over the island.
Yeah, I mean, definitely. I mean, I think it showed that we are a team, that we all work together and we work for the people together rather than individualism.
As a young Republican woman, how did you find that work for you?
Oh, I think it worked brilliantly, you know. I had the support from the other candidates and from Matt Carthy himself throughout the campaign, and that definitely helped me.
In terms of when you were knocking the doors and other young women coming out, were they surprised to see?
Well, I think the first comment that most people said is, God, you're very small. But after that, I think they were happy to see, you know, other young women out there and, you know, fighting their kind of corner.
Seems to be a huge interest in the media for our young candidates.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I've been getting calls from the media non-stop really since I was elected. So it's good. I mean, it's positive. It shows that they realise that we are a force to be reckoned with now. It's been very clear in this election that people see that Sinn Féin deliver. We deliver in the north, and we've certainly shaken things up in the Dáil. And who knows what will happen in the next general election. I think that people are ready to have Team Sinn Féin in the Dáil.
Matt Carthy, Sinn Féin, plus 7,911. As the votes of Matt Carthy have now exceeded the quota, I deem him to be elected. Thank you.
lawyer died the public honey or put in the land in the hearing. Neil Orla went a porch at the Nilancho, now will an ish pressure of Europe at Jenny Frasteller. I guess all Inta Broadwell, the public honey at a Hannick Hoganilla. Couple of million was August public honey telling la bianta bianta father. A we extra helsly len amon a cruella and bluish no honat last the Gahari and Condaya Castle Jean Mayo, Tisha Inta Broadwood Duny Lake, August Bar, Inta Moy and Matt Carty, Tuffa and Ash Gazay, Egal and Ash Gajin Europe, Lishan, Tree, Fresher Europe, Ella. Well, an absolutely historic and fabulous day to be an Irish Republican. You know, just to think that Sinn Féin now has four MEPs across the island of Ireland, that there's not an inch of Ireland that isn't represented by a Sinn Féin MEP is just absolutely fantastic, not just for this generation of Irish Republicans, but for Republicans, and I know Matt is very mindful of this here, who struggled in very, very difficult times, who stood in these elections like Eddie Fullerton and others, who canvassed, who supported, who campaigned for this, to bring this day about, and it's just beautiful the fact that we have four MEPs, Matt Carthy, a real ambassador, a real leader for our movement and for our party, and joining Martina Anderson, Lynn and Leanne Uribe, a fantastic team to fight Ireland's corner in Brussels and Strasbourg in the year ahead.
Matt Carthy, Cogarges, August Furin, Sinn Féin, what's it feel like to be elected as MEP?
Well, it's still only sinking in, I have to say, although with the length this count has taken, it should have had enough time, but I just want to take this opportunity to thank those people who voted Sinn Féin last Friday, to thank particularly the Sinn Féin local election candidates, because I believe firmly that the reason we won this seat is because our election candidates were ensuring that the European campaign was brought to every doorstep. That's what we had that the other political parties didn't have, and particularly I want to thank those hundreds and thousands of Sinn Féin members and party activists who were involved in this campaign in any way at all, and particularly those people who have been involved in a lot of campaigns that didn't end so successfully. We were reflecting earlier on that a previous European candidate was Eddie Fullerton. This week marks his anniversary. There was a time when it wasn't not only a popular thing, but it was actually a dangerous thing to stand up in this state or in the northern state and say, I am an Irish Republican. The results this weekend have showed that tens and hundreds of thousands of people across this island are now saying, we are Irish Republicans, we want a change in the political system, we want a united Ireland, we want equality and fairness at the heart of our society, and we never again want to have governments who actually encourage and force our young people out of our communities and into different countries. So I think this was a milestone in Irish politics. I think it's marked a turning point. I think the days of Fianna Fáil and Fine Gael domination of politics in this state are now over, and what we have as a responsibility of as a party is to deliver for those communities who have entrusted us with their support, and we will deliver. We have been delivering in the Dáil. Our TDs have deservedly earned a reputation for people who put the hard questions, who hold institutions to account. We need to do the same now at local government and at European Parliament level, and we intend to do just that.
Of course you'll be joined by Lynn, Leah and Martina. Do you not think that's a bit of an unfair advantage in Europe?
Yeah, well, I do think it was important that we had a little bit of gender balance in the Sinn Féin team, because I'm actually the first Sinn Féin male MEP, I do think that Martina has been an excellent and an outstanding MEP already. I think her experience is going to be invaluable to us, but I think Lynn and Leah will prove to be outstanding representatives in their own right, and I hope to be able to join that team as part of an all-Ireland team of Sinn Féin MEPs who are bringing the message very clearly to the European Parliament and to the European institutions that austerity hasn't worked. It's actually, rather than solve the crisis, it's actually prolonged the crisis, that the banking debt, the money that has been taken off Irish taxpayers and pumped into toxic banks, needs to be returned so that we can invest that in our community, and we need to ensure that European funding is secured so that we can create the jobs, not only the investment in communities, but in the communities that need it most, those communities that have been devastated by lack of government investment and by forced emigration over the past number of years.
Political pundits have been saying the team Sinn Féin brand has meant a lot on the doorsteps. Have you found that too?
I have no doubt I got elected because I was a Sinn Féin representative. I came into this election as a completely unknown outside of my home county constituency of Cavan Monaghan and perhaps Roscommon, where I spent some of my childhood. But it was down to the respect that Sinn Féin has earned in communities right across these 15 counties that we secured this seat. And this is a victory, not for me, I have to say, but for those Sinn Féin activists who have been around and been involved in much quieter election counts where the results just didn't go our way. This is a vindication for them, and I know that many of the people here today celebrating this victory are thinking about others who are not here to see it, but we know that they're with us and that the spirit that they had remains with us, and we are as determined as they were to secure that united Ireland, that Irish Republic that so many have given so much for.